Hello, welcome to Windshine Audio channel. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Alvin, owner of Windshine Audio. Today, I'm going to share with you some of the operation details, tricks that you can do with this Denafrips Pontus II DAC. It is a mid-range DAC offered by Denafrips, sitting in between the Aries 2 and the Venus 2. One of the most popular model. It is popular because of the sound quality, of course, and it is popular also because of the price range. It is selling for 2,298 Singapore dollars, and price subject to change. In case you are watching this video a couple of years later, the price may have increased slightly to combat inflation. I hope you understand this. And so let's tune in to talk about this Pontus II DAC. It's made of full aluminium, thick front panel aluminium, top cover, side panel, and the back panel are full aluminium. So compared to the Aries 2, Aries 2 is made of sheet metal for the body, for the chassis, and the front panel of the Aries 2 is aluminium. But for the Pontus 2, is fully aluminium all over it. And it's pretty heavy, it's about 12 kilograms. Despite having a pair of pretty strong arms, it's difficult to lift it up like this on a desk. Let me flip it to the back to show you what is available at the back panel. We have a FuryTech IEC connector. This portion here are the digital inputs that you can use to connect to the digital source that you have, ranging from coaxial input for RCA, BNC connector, two AES EBU. It can be used as a single AES EBU input or dual AES EBU input in case you have some of the equipment that can output dual AES EBU output to this Pontus II DAC. So it is the dual AES EBU input is supported by the Pontus II DAC. And we have optical input, R2S input, and the USB input. And for output, we have a pair of RCA and a pair of XLR output. It is a true balance stack. So if your downstream amplifier is true balance, it is recommended to use the XLR output. It sounds better than the RCA. But if the equipment that you are using downstream is single added, you can use the RCA output instead. It is important to note that the output of the RCA and XLR are shared. It is recommended to connect one at a time, but not both simultaneously. Connecting both RCA and XLR output may have an adverse effect to the sound quality. So refer to the link below for some recommendation in case you need to use the XLR and RCA output at the same time. So let me flip it to the front, and I'll just turn on the power to show you the operation of this Pontus II DAC. Right, I have a basic power cord here. We do not ship the unit with power cord because at this level, we believe the basic power cord will likely end up in the trash. So we don't ship this generic power cord in the package. And I always recommend the customer to use studio grade cable. This is a cable from Gotten, Switzerland. It is used in pro audio industry or broadcasting or studio environment. It is inexpensive and the quality is pretty good. So I always recommend the customer to use a good quality cable from brands like Sommer Cable, Gotten, Mogami, Belden, or Canary, and etc. So these are the cables that is used in studio environment. They are good quality and inexpensive. It is highly recommended. So this is the power cord that I use in almost all of my setup. On my desk, in my hi-fi room, or in my second setup at the hall. Right. And for interconnect, you may consider Sommer cable. It is a studio broadcasting quality. It's a pretty good one. And do consider using good quality cable for optimum result of using Denafrips DAC or any other equipment that in your system. So I have this basic power cord here for demonstration. The voltage is auto switching, so it can be used in environment like, if, for example, if you are in the US, the voltage in US is 120, and for voltage in the UK, Europe, or Singapore like me is 240. The voltage will be auto-detected by the microprocessor inside this DAC, and it will switch a couple of relay inside internally to send the correct power or correct voltage to the transformer. So upon plugging in the power cord, you should be able to hear a couple of relay clicking sound coming from the unit itself. So wait for about 3 to 5 seconds for it to finalize, for it to start up before pressing the buttons at the front. So once I plug in the power cord, you should be able to hear a couple of relay clicking sound. I hope the microphone is strong enough to pick it up, and let's see. Plug in the power cord. Okay, we hear a relay clicking sound, and there's another one as I speak, so I hope you can hear it. So once the power is selected correctly by the relay, you will notice that the standby LED turned on. So the standby LED turned on tells us that the unit is power on, and it is in standby mode. So to turn on this guy, just simply press on the power button or the standby button. You'll hear another relay clicking sound, and the standby button LED will be off, and the rest of the button here, or the rest of the LED here, will light up depending on what is the last input that you use. There are a couple of buttons here for you to choose the input that you want to use. Currently, it is selected as CO1, so press on the input plus button to change the input. CO2, optical, AES1, AES2, USB, and I2S. So this is the input plus for you to change the input from the left to the right. So input minus will be changing the input from the right to the left. So press on the input minus, and the input selection will go from the right to the left. So depending on which input you would like to use, just select the correct input by using the input plus and minus button. So there are a couple of more buttons here. Phase button is to change the phase, the polarity of the phase, positive phase or negative phase. There's no hard rule for the phase configuration of the DAC. It is system dependent. It is depending on the connected amplifier or the source or the loudspeaker. So you may trial and error to set the phase to positive or negative phase to suit your taste and to find optimal sound quality by using this phase button here. And we have NOS or OS button here for you to choose the sampling mode of the DAC. So press on this button, OS or NOS button, and toggle it. So as you toggle this button, you notice that the LED turn on and off as you toggle this button. So leave the LED on for NOS, and leave the LED off for OS. For OS, Denafrips comes with two filter settings, slow filter and sharp filter. So how do we change this setting? It's a little bit more complicated because there's no display on the deck itself. We need to make use of the button here and for configuration. And the configuration status will be displayed by a series of combination of the LED status. So I know it is kind of complicated, but as you do the setting or as you practice more, you will familiarize yourself, you'll get accustomed to the setting, and it can be done quite easily. So how do we change the filter for OS mode? Press on the mute button once, the mute will engage, and the LED turn on from the left to the right. So the input LED turn on from the left to the right. In case you have the music playing, as the mute engage, the music will stop. And at this point in time, it is in mute mode, and it can also be a configuration mode. So press on the mode button here to change the filter. So as you toggle this mode button, you notice that the OPT LED turn on and off. On top of that, we also have USB LED turn on. So it tells us that it is in configuration mode and filter selection is being toggled. As you can see, the optical LED turn on and off. Leave the LED on for slow filter. Leave the LED off for sharp filter. I personally prefer the slow filter, so I'll leave the optical LED on. And after a couple of seconds later, the DAC will be back to operation mode, where the previously selected input will light up, the LED will light up, and if it is streaming music from the transport, the sampling rate will light up as well. Because I have not connected to any source, so the previous selected input LED light up, and there's no sampling rate because the CO2 is not connected to any transport. So this is back to normal operation. A couple more settings that you might be interested is, in case you use I2S input, move the input selection to I2S, and I2S pinout has to be configured. So Denafrips DAC comes with I2S pinout configuration. It can be done by pressing a series of button here. With the help of the LED, you will be able to know the pinout selection of the Pontus DAC itself, or Denafrips Venus 2, Terminator 2, or the Terminator Plus DAC. So how do we do this? It's pretty similar to the filter selection. Press on the mute button once, the mute engage, the LED turn on and off from the left to the right, and press on the face button multiple times. As you press on the face button multiple times, you can see that the 1x, 2x, and 4x LED turn on and off. So this is for pinout configuration for I2S input. I have another detailed video to demonstrate how do you configure the I2S to match with the source correctly. So please refer to that video. Yeah, it is more comprehensive. But for this video, I'm just going to talk about some basic operation of the Pontus 2 DAC. So I cover filter selection, I cover NOS and OS mode selection, I cover the phase as well as the I2S pinout configuration. The next thing will be hook it up to the computer system and start playing some music. So I have here a Pontus DAC, a Hestia preamp, and a pair of active loudspeaker from Genelec. So I'm going to use my Rune Core. It is a computer right over here, Windows 10 computer with a Rune Core installed. And I'll be connecting the USB cable to the Pontus DAC. And I'm using a Windows computer. It is mandatory or required to install the Denafrips USB driver onto the USB onto the Windows computer so that the USB driver can be used correctly. If you did not install the driver, please install it. The driver is available to download from the Denafrips website. I have provided the link below as well. So please download the driver and install it on the Windows computer. And if for those of you who use Mac computer or Linux computer, there's no driver required, so you do not need to install the driver. And in fact, there's no driver required for Mac or Linux computer. It is just plug and play. Right, for Windows computer, please install the driver. And because I have the Windows computer driver installed already, as soon as I plug in the USB cable and select the USB input, the computer should detect the USB DAC right away. And select the USB input. So as I select the USB input, you can see that the 44K1 and 1X LED turn on. This sampling rate tells us that the DAC is receiving 44.1 kHz sampling rate from the computer. So launch the Rune software on the computer and we should be able to start playing some music. Let's see. You notice that the Hestia preamp is not powered on because the DAC is essentially connected to another Hestia preamp right over here. The Hestia preamp is here is just to show you that please use a proper preamp for active loudspeaker. I do not usually recommend the digital volume control because it is still lossy in a sense. I always recommend to use a proper preamp like the Hestia preamp or any other preamp that can have proper analog volume control instead of digital volume control. Right, let's play some music from Celine Dion. Do I have the input selected correctly? Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't connect the XLR output. So the XLR cable that I have here are from Sonor Cable, the yellow color one. And because the DAC is true balance, if the downstream equipment that you are connecting to is true balance, please use XLR cable. So connect the XLR cable to the DAC itself. And as soon as I hit the play button, the Hestia preamp and the Genelec loudspeaker should play some music. Right. So my heart will go on from Celine Dion. Right, it is playing 44K1, so in PCM mode. In case you have some DSD or high resolution track from your computer, it can be played as well. So let me show you how to play a DSD track from the Rune computer. Alright, I think I'll just upsample this. Rune is pretty powerful, you can upsample the music to different sampling rates. Perhaps I'll just show some sampling rate conversion of this 44K1 to... it's pretty complicated. 44K, 2X, and 8X. It is 16 times 48 kHz, which is 768 kHz sampling rate coming from the computer to the DAC. And the DAC is decoding the 768 kHz music track and send it to the downstream equipment. And if you change the sampling to, let's say for example, 192, 48K and 4X on, it is playing 192 kHz. And if you change it to DSD, if you upsample it to DSD, DSD 512, I hope the computer can play it. 8 times DSD, it is DSD 512. And you notice that 44K1 LED lights up here, is because the DSD 512 received from the computer, from the rune call, is 44.1 kHz base. So there's DSD in 48 kHz. So if you use HQ player, you'll know about this. HQ player is another topic altogether. We'll talk about this in another video. So this is how you play music from the Windows computer to the Pontus II DAC and output it to your preamp or power amp or a pair of active loudspeaker. So I hope this video helps. Thank you so much. See you next time.